Hello, everyone. Welcome back. If you're back, or welcome for the first time, if this is your first time, thank you for joining me. This is the ECD Style and Technique class. I'm Renee Camus. I'm happy to have you here. I want to say a quick thank you to HTDS, the Historical Tea and Dance Society, and particularly Lindsay Verbal for helping out with all the tech stuff. She's here, and I'm so grateful to have her. And thanks to Darlene Hamilton also for sharing her Zoom account with me for this. So, all right. I watched the video from last week and I was very distracted by the chat bar. There is a chat bar, as you notice. If you go to the bottom, you can see, you might be able to see the other participants, but you can see the chat bar. And there's a Q&A bar. If you have any questions or comments, you can use those things. But I will say that I'm gonna try not to look at it as frequently as I did last week, because it was it was very distracting. And the video is a lot of me going, oh yeah, okay, cool, right. And that's not a good class. So. And I know I cannot see you. There was a question. I cannot see you. Hopefully you can see me and hear me, but you are all muted and I cannot see you. So that's good for some people and maybe not so good for other people. Yeah, so if you have questions or comments, feel free to use the chat. All caps helps. Because I'll often be standing back there. Okay, so we're going to get started with a warm-up. We're going to do a ballet warm-up, because I, a sort of mix of ballet and jazz, because I firmly believe that ballet is the building blocks of all dance. And when done properly, when done correctly, it can increase your longevity of dancing life. It can reduce injury. When it's done properly, and it makes you a better dancer and certainly more graceful dancer. So we're going to do some ballet warm-ups. We'll hopefully get faster with them as the weeks go and you get more comfortable with them. I'll be doing the same thing to the same music week after week, just so we get comfortable with the warm-up, and then we can get more into things afterward. I will say again, make sure to listen to your body, okay? If you need to modify the movements because of whatever, you know, injuries or whatever issues you may have, please feel free. For one thing, I can't see you. But for another, you want to make sure that you're safe. We don't want any injuries, right? So you wanna listen to your body. That means if you need to leave some things out, that's fine. Also, if you need to do some stretch or something that I'm not having you do, go ahead and do it. That's fine. You can push yourself a little bit, you know, for stretches. You want to deepen those stretches and get better as the weeks go on, but we don't want pain and we don't want injury. Okay. So things to keep in mind as we do our warm up. All right. Let's get started, I guess. So by the way, if you like my t-shirt, it's Titanic. It was drawn by my husband, Alex, and it's available on TeePublic. Sorry. Okay, here we go. So I'll put music on. We're going to start with stretching. 2, 3, 4, and then push the air down. We'll do that again. La, 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 la. You know. And so as I reach, I'm stretching a little bit up the side here and stretch and stretch and then push the air down. We'll do that twice. Then I'll do a flat back. Bend my knees, roll through my back, and stretch down here for a bit. Okay, we'll do some stuff here. Then I'll bend my knees. You want to tuck your tush under, right? And slowly, one vertebra at a time, roll up through your spine, leaving your head heavy, neck and head for last. Okay, we'll do that again. We'll do some other things. Okay, I thought I saw a question. We'll also roll down. Just drop your head nice and heavy and roll down through the spine. Bend your knees. Hang there for a bit. Stretch. If you need to keep your knees bent, that is perfectly fine. Again, listen to your body. All right, we'll stay there for a bit. If you feel like you want to walk your hands out, if you're on the ground, you can do that. That's fine. and we'll roll back up. We'll do some side stretches. Don't bounce, just hang. Let the weight of your body take you deeper into the stretch. We'll go to the other side, and we'll do some more stuff, okay? You can follow along. I think you should, hopefully you should be able to hear me over the music. Hi. Hopefully you'll be able to hear me over the music, and so you'll be able to follow along, okay? Here we go. Oh, really quickly, I want to say thank you to the Bare Necessities who have graciously given me permission to use their music for this class. If you are willing and able to give a donation either to them or to me, we would be greatly appreciate it. And the information was on at the beginning and will be on again at the end. So thank you for that. All the first few tunes are going to be from their album, The Nightcap, which if you heard Kate Barnes talking yesterday, was the album she talked about a lot. So, so here we go. All right. Nice and relaxed. Here we go. Ready? Right hand. Three, two, three, and four. Push the air down. Five, six. Really push the air. Do that again. And stretch. Two, three, and four. Push the air. Six, seven. Relax your neck. Relax your shoulders. Flat back. Bend your knees and roll down to the floor. Stretch here. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. Bend your knees. Bend your knees and try to stretch a little bit more. Straighten them as much as you can. Bend your knees and roll up nice and slow. Tuck the tailbone under. One vertebrae at a time. Bring your head left. Good, shake it out. Let's just drop the head down. Drop the head down and roll through the spine. Nice and slow, nice and gentle. Bend those knees. And stretch here. Relax your head. Relax your neck. Bend your knees. And straighten them. Stay down, send your hips to the ceiling. If you can, walk your hands out in front of you. Walk your hands out. And walk them back. Bend your knees, tuck your tailbone under, and roll up. Nice and relaxed, nice and slow. Lean over to the right side, over to your right. Relax your shoulder. Try not to crunch through your side here. Lift it up. And over to your left side, or yes, left side. Keep breathing. Make sure you're breathing. Good, and relax. Open your knees to the side, turn your knees out, and do a nice deep bend. Make sure that your knees are over your toes, directly over your toes. Don't let them lean inward. Yeah. You want to put your shoulder forward. Yeah. And put the other shoulder forward. Good. Turn your feet parallel and lean over, lean down. Relax your head, relax your neck. Bend those knees and straighten. And bend your knees and roll up. Nice and relaxed. All right, good. Shake it out. What am I forgetting? Anything? I don't think so. Oh, let's do, let's do this. Interlace your fingers behind your back and lean back And then lean forward. Bring your arms, you're still interlaced, bring your arms up behind you. And then turn sideways. And relax your hands, let them go, reach to the floor, or as close to the floor as you can, that's fine. Relax your head, relax your head. And bend your knees and pull up. Left foot behind you, either foot, take a foot, I don't care, and put it behind you and put it straight back so you feel a stretch of the calf, stretch at the back of the leg. If you want, you can push your hip forward so you're going to stretch right through this front muscle here, psoas. And shake it out. Do your other leg, whichever leg you didn't do before. Make sure that back foot is straight, right? Not turned out. Straight forward, feel a stretch up the back of the leg. All right. Good, and shake it out. Let's do a, oh, by the way, you can use, yeah, that's fine. Let's do a, thigh stretch, you can use a bar or, you know, whatever, a shelf or a table or a chair, whatever, to balance if you need it. Apparently I do for now. And feel a stretch up the thigh here. Breathe into that stretch. And shake it out. I like to do this, you don't have to. And switch to your other leg. It's very warm in my room. Breathe into that stretch. And shake it out. Good. All right. Woo. How's everybody doing? Feeling good? I can't see you, but hopefully you're feeling good. All right. So we'll do, yeah. All right, I want to talk very quickly for a minute about posture. I said this last week too, but you want to sort of think of all the different parts of your body as blocks, right? So your legs, your calves are a block, your knees are a block, your hips are a block, especially in the upper part. Your ribs are a block, your torso, your shoulders are a block, your neck and head is a block, and everything is sort of stacked straight in a straight line, more or less, on top of each other, right? It's not a straight line because we have little spaces, a curve in our back and things like that, but everything is on top of each other and stacked in alignment, okay? I said this last week, your pelvis, right, is like a bowl. You can think of your pelvis as a bowl, and if it's straight, then nothing is going to fall out of the bowl. But if it tips in some direction, then everything that's in the bowl is going to fall out, right? And that's usually the more common thing that happens is we arch our back and our butt sticks out and then everything kind of falls out the front. Some people are tucked in that way, right? If we're concave this way, then everything's going to fall out the back, yeah? So we don't want that. We want everything to be nice and strong and tall and lifted, okay? You can also think of like of yourself as like a puppet with a string coming out the top of your head, sort of the back of the crown, and lifting upward toward the ceiling, right? So everything is tall and lifted and strong, right? Okay, we'll do some foot work. Again, I'll put the music on, but we're gonna do ankle rolls. If you need to use something to balance, that's fine. Nice big circles, ooh, on one foot in one direction outside. We'll do 8 of them and then we'll stop and go back the other direction. Nice and big, try to isolate the ankle. Don't move your leg, just move the ankle or the foot, okay? Then we'll change feet Do the other side. La, 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 la. We'll do it with music. We'll do some pliés. I'd like a nice, gentle first position, right? So my feet are turned out just a little bit. And it will vary how turned out your feet are, right? But the most important thing is when you plié, make sure your knees are directly over your toes, right? Don't let them turn inward, okay? Directly over your toes. Make sure everything else stays stacked and tall, right? Don't stick your butt up. How lovely. Yeah, no. Just down and up. This all stays straight and just the knees bend. Okay, so we'll do some pliés. And up and then relevé, straight up onto the ball of your foot and down again. Plié, relevé, relevé, heels down. Plié, we'll do a few of those. Then we'll go straight through, plié to the relevé, plié to the relevé. We'll do those a few times, yes? Yes. Okay. Sorry, I missed a question. I'll come back to it. Plié and relevé. Then we'll do pressed arches, and I cannot believe I forgot to do this last week. I showed it to you, and then we didn't actually do it, but I like to do parallel for this. You're going to do press. You're going to sort of dig the toe into the floor and then put the heel down. Press the toe into the floor and then push through the toe to a point, okay? So it's not a big kick. I'm not kicking. I'm just sort of pushing through the floor and then back to the toe and then heel down. Then we'll do the other foot. Toe, point. Pressed arch, heel down. Pressed arch, point. Pressed arch, heel down. Pressed arch, point. Pressed arch, heel down. We'll do that a bunch of times. We'll do it faster. And then we'll go straight to the point. Point, point. Like a little prancing horsey. And we'll do it faster, etc. But you really want to roll through the foot. Articulate every piece of the foot to get that prancing thing. Okay, excuse me. So we'll do all that with music, starting with our ankle rolls. That last tune was Chestnut. This one is the St. Martin's Lane. Oh, it's a crooked tune too, but we'll just go with it. Ready with your right foot, six. Five, six, ankle rolls, nice and big. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other way, one, two, three. Hear everything crackling. Five, six, seven. Change feet. And one, two, three, four, six, seven, eight, reverse, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Good, plié, and up, relevé, and down. Plié, and up, relevé, and down. Plié, up, relevé, heels down. Plié, keep your butt in, and relevé. Plié, up, relevé, and down. Plié, up, relevé, and straight through. Plié, relevé, plié, relevé, plié, relevé, plié, relevé, plié, relevé, plié, relevé. Two more, and up, and one more. And hold it right there. Try to hold your balance. Nice and strong, ankles right on top of the toes. Oh, I'm wavering. Hopefully you're doing better. Arms out to the side helps you balance. If you feel like you've got that, look to your left. And look to your right. And relax, good. Shake it out for a second, let me see. Oh. I'll get back to that question in a moment. All right. And we'll do our pressed arches. Starting with your right foot. And press, point,
press, heel down. Or other foot, press, point, press, heel down. Right, press, heel down. And left, point, press, heel down. Again. Two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. One more. Double time, here we go. Press, point, press, heel down. Press, point. Press, point, press, heel down. 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 Press, heel down. Press, point, press, heel. Good, to the point. And point, and point, and point. And point, roll through the foot, roll through the foot, roll, roll, point, the music's ending. Good. Double time, and press, two, three, four, prance, nice, one foot to the other, press, press, two, three, four, five, six, double time again, and one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and she's a maniac, yeah, you get it. Press, 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 roll through your foot each time, nice, gentle heels landing, yeah? Good, and relax, slow it down a little bit, good, shake it out, all right. Okay, so, excuse me. Get a little drink of water. By the way, you don't have to wait for me to get water. If you need to get more water, please feel free. But I also should have you drink more water anyway, and I should do it myself. How are we doing? Feeling good? Okay, whew. It's so warm in this room. Okay, so there were a couple of questions. One was, Alan asked if the thigh stretch, if it's okay to use the other hand, like the right hand on the left ankle. Do I even know how to do that? I think so, but I don't think you get, I don't know if you get quite the same stretch. You can sort of play with it and feel, and you wanna make sure, you wanna make sure that you do not have a pull in your knee ligaments, right? You don't want, the stretch is here in the thigh. And if you feel pain in the knee, then you might need to adjust a little bit. And then Sarah Harriman asked, what makes a tune crooked? we can talk more about that later. And this is probably not exactly a crooked tune because crooked is probably more weird and mixed up than this tune is. But what I mean by that basically is most tunes are 32 bars. It's getting a little technical. Most tunes are like 16 beats for the first part and then 16 beats for the second part. And this tune has 20 beats for the second part, like 16 beats for the first part and then 20 beats for the second part. So it has a couple extra bars in there. And when you're dancing, the choreography, the figures of the dance go with it. So you don't necessarily notice it. It doesn't sound off or anything. But if you're just doing exercises, then sometimes you notice. So that's what I mean by the crooked tune. I hope that's helpful. okay, we'll do our next... Our next exercise. We're gonna do some more, and this is where the real ballet warm-up comes in. We're gonna do a nice gentle first position again, arms to the side. We'll do tendu. So I want you to slide your foot across the floor to a point. I don't know if you can see my feet. Point, yes? And then close. We'll go point, then flex, then point, and then close. Then point. Close, point, close. Then we'll do the same thing on the left foot, on the other foot. Point, flex, point, and close. point and close, point and close. Okay, then we'll do the same thing to the side. And I mentioned this last week, it's not directly to the side because you want to follow where your hip is lined up. You want to follow the alignment of your hip. So if your toe, whoops, that's weird. You want to follow, if your toe is pointing here, you're just going to follow the line of your toe. Hi, cat, you're in the way. Follow the line of your toe. So it's more like a diagonal, right? Point, flex, point, close, point, and close, point, and close. Then the other side, point, flex, point, close, point, close, point, close. Then we go to the back. Point to the back. Straight back. Relax your tush, right? Don't let your butt tense up. Flex, point, close, point, close. Other foot, la, 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 la. And then to the side again. So it's front, front, side. Actually, I'll do this. Front, front, side, side, back, back, side, side. Okay? And then we'll do it again. But the second time, we'll do it with a dégagé, which means we'll do tendu, flex, point, close, then a slight lift off the floor. Lift and close. Lift and close. Then the other leg. Point, flex, point, close, and lift and close. Lift and close. Okay? Then side, side, back, back, side, side. All right? By the way, you may have noticed, I'm trying to do my left foot, but call it the right foot so that you are doing the same leg as I am. But I forget sometimes, so apologies. All right, here we go. Whew. This is the first lady. This tune. And there's a nice lengthy introduction on it, so. Ready? And arms up. To the side. Here we go. Right foot and tendu. Flex, point, and close. Tendu, point, and close. Point, and close. Other foot. Point, flex, point, close. Everything nice and tall. Lift it up. To the side. Right. Flex, point, and close. Point, and close. To the other side. Point, flex. To the back, straight back, relax your tush. Close, point, and close. Other side, point, flex, point, woo! Point, and close, point, and close. Side, one, two, three, four, point, close. Slide your foot along the floor. Other side, point. Close, point, and relax. Good. Relax your arms. Shake it out. Bend over. You can do a stretch down here if you want to. And we'll do it with the dégagé. Ready? Arms forward and side. Here we go. And out. Flex, point, and close, and lift. Small lift. Hips straight. Other side, other foot. Point, and close, and lift, and close. Relax your shoulders. Side. Flex, and lift. Body's nice and tall. Other side. Close, lift, and close to the back. Flex, point, and close. Lift, close, lift. I got a wall back there. Other foot. Relax your tush. Lift. And side. Shift the weight. Everything tall and lifted, but you just shift over. Other side. Almost there. Keep breathing. Lift and close. Lift. And close. Good. Relax. Shake your arms out. Shake everything out. Hi, kitty. Oh, all right. Good. How are we feeling? Everybody feeling good? Whew. All right, any questions? Everybody doing okay? Take some more water, make sure you drink water. Whew. Goodness gracious. I don't know about y'all, but I'm working hard. Okay. All right, we're gonna do one more warm-up thing. And then we'll get into other stuff. So I love this warm-up thing. We're going to do slides, and I'm on a carpet, so I don't want to touch any metal after this. But and hopefully you have enough room to do this. It takes a little bit more room. It's almost more of a, it's less of a ballet exercise and maybe more of a jazz one. I don't know. But we did it last week also. So we're going to do H's. I'm going to take... I'm gonna start with my right foot, your right foot, my left, your right foot. We're gonna go forward, touch, and back, touch. So I don't change weight, right? I didn't do that. I just did a touch, and then back, and then I'm gonna go chasse to the side, side together, side. Then I'm gonna do the other foot, forward and back, forward, touch, pardon me, and side together, side. Then I'm gonna go backward. Back, touch, forward, touch, and side together, side, and then other foot back, forward, side together, side. Okay, so it's a big H. I do the top half of the H first and sort of reinforce it, then I do the bottom half of the H and reinforce it. Okay, and it's always the foot on the inside of your H that starts. Okay, so. We'll do it to the same music, and then we'll do it to a fast, slightly faster piece of music. All right, here we go. Ready? And forward, back, side together, side, other foot forward, back, side together, right foot back. Yeah, do it again. Forward. Other foot forward. Side together. Backward. Oh, sorry, kitty. Oh, gosh. Oh, baby. Once again. Forward. And forward. Sorry, the music ran out. Side together. Backward. One, two. Side together. Side and back. Two, side together, side. Good. Oh, I feel terrible. I stepped on my poor kitten. Oh. All right. Any questions on that? We'll do it one more time to a slightly faster music, I believe. It certainly feels faster. I love this exercise because after all of that pull up and strong and everything kind of, you know, hopefully not. But a little bit, here we get to just kind of let loose a little bit, right? And relax, and you can let your arms swing, right? You wanna really use that bend, feel that downward bend in the floor, that plie, yeah? But we still have a strong, nice, proper alignment that everything lifted, even though we're relaxed and loose, okay? Let's try it one more time. It's so fun. This tune is working too. Six, five, six, right foot forward, forward, back, side together, side, other foot forward, back, side together, back, side together, side, and other foot back, forward, side together, side, forward, one, two, side together, and forward, and back. To the back and back and stop together. Yes, good. Woo. All right. So that tune was King of Poland. Super fun dance. All right. Whew, how are we doing? Feeling good? Hopefully, I can't see you, of course, but hopefully you are feeling good. Water's very important. Speaking of seeing you all, please feel free to join us afterward. When this class is over at 7, we'll do a little chat. Give us a minute or two to set it up, but we'll do a little chat on the Zoom. So, and it's a separate link, which I'll send out after class. So check your email for that. And it'll be, then we can all sort of chat and see each other's faces and stuff, and that'll be fun. So it'll be good to know who's out there. All right, of course you don't have to join, but it'd be great if you did. Okay, so I wanted to do, again, I really think these warm-ups are important because they, as I said, they're the building blocks of dance, and they really help, oh, I know what I'm going to do. They really help to make you better dancers. And the most important thing, I think, for this type of dancing, for English country dance, are the pressed arches. Remember that we did this press and point and press heel down, which I remembered to do this time, right? Those, that rolling through the foot, right? That is probably the most important thing of all these things. And even when I did it faster, I still have that same motion, that same rolling through the foot, right? And rolling back down again, okay? And that articulation of the foot is what helps you get a nice, first of all, it looks nice, but it's also cleaner. It helps you give you a nice soft landing rather than, you know what I mean? This kind of, right? It's nice and gentle, right? And it also helps you, that articulation helps you dance on the music a little bit more because you can sort of change the speed of how you work through the foot depending on the speed of the music. Hopefully that makes sense. I think it will more as we go. I see a question. How much weight do you put on the ball when you're doing pressed arches? Yes, is the other foot flat or does it come up? Good question. So I mostly have my weight on my back foot or the foot that's not doing the press. Right? But I can sort of press into that for a little bit of a stretch if I want to. But then, of course, I can't have weight on it to roll off the foot. Otherwise, I'll fall forward, right? So you can sort of press into the floor, literally, but you don't have to. And when we're in the midst of doing the exercise with music telling us to keep moving, then it's even less of a weight, okay? But you see also that I'm shifting my weight pretty quickly from one foot to the other, especially when we go faster, right? Hopefully that helps, yeah? Okay. So we did this last week, but I want to do it again. Let's just walk a little bit, okay? I want you to walk, no music yet, just walk around your room, or wherever you are. If you want to step out for more room and come back, that's fine. But I want you to just think about what your body is doing as you walk normally. Okay? So just kind of walk around. What do you notice about your body? What do you notice? For example, I scuff my feet sometimes. Especially if I'm wearing not dance shoes, like when I'm wearing my house slippers, I scuff my feet a lot. My body gets a little more sort of, not quite like that, but a little rocking and rolling, right? Yeah. But now let's put some music on and I want you to walk to music. Okay. And think about what your body is doing while you're walking to music. Let's see. I'll do the same tune I did last time. Oh, by the way, if you don't think about what is this, let's see, somebody said, yes, shoulders can tend to slump. Absolutely. My body rock and rolls. I think less about my posture when I'm just walking normally. Yeah. So let's try walking with music. And again, if you know the dances, if you are very familiar with the figures, try not to think of the figures. Try not to say, oh, wait, well, I know this tune. What tune is this? I do that all the time. Just walk. Okay, here we go. Walk around, you know, forward and back, sideways. All right. So, if you have any thoughts, how is it different? How was it different this time when you were walking to music? For me, I definitely stand up straighter, at least a little bit straighter. I walk with purpose. Foot came down more strongly on the beat, Suzanne said. Yes, definitely. Deborah said, I moved forward more. Absolutely. Yeah. Yes, all these things happen. It's true. So it feels different, right? And that's good. That's good if those things naturally happen when we're walking. But then we can maybe try to think about some of them more. What I notice, for example, is that I definitely have a little lift in my foot, right? I have a little, and it's that same exercise. It's rolling through the foot, right? Sometimes I step with the heel first. Sometimes I step with the toe first. Usually forward, it's the heel first. Backwards, it's the toe first. But sometimes I'll go toe first going forward too. Sort of depends on where I'm going and what strikes me, yeah? But I definitely have, it's mesmerizing, isn't it? That roll through the foot, okay? So there's a little lift, there's a little bounce in my step. Sounds like a cliche, but it's true. And again, my posture is stronger. My weight generally, I'm just checking some notes actually. My weight is generally on the balls of my feet, right? Not falling forward, but I am moving forward, right? So it's almost, sometimes, almost as if I catch myself, right? But you also don't want to be, you know, literally falling forward. Everything's still straight, posture strong, all of that, yeah? So it's somewhere in between, somewhere in the middle, yeah? Also, even if I do something smoother, right? Smoothing out my steps, I'm still articulating my foot, yeah? I'm still rolling through the foot as I'm going. May not be as much of a prance, and maybe smoother, but I still have a little bit of that roll through the foot. And that roll through the foot is also what helps me land on the beat and land on time, because it gives me more control, yeah? That articulation of the foot gives me more control over when my foot hits the floor. Okay? I hope that makes sense. So let's do some more. I just want to play different pieces of music. Ooh la la. Oh yeah. So that was Elverton Grove, in case you're curious. Let's do this one. This is, well, you'll notice. Anywhere, you can do a circle or back to back or sideways, zigzag, whatever you want. What happens to your body? So, notice anything different? Obviously, that was a slower tune. It was a slower tune, so we move a little bit different, right? Our steps can be a little bit longer Well, when you have the space for them. But yes, and then faster, you have to go a little bit shorter steps, right? But again, you can still use that articulation of the foot to help you land on the beat. Let's see. Let's try another piece of music. And again, feel free to jump into the chat or the Q&A. There's a little Q&A box if you have questions. Let's do... What's this? Okay, so I'm going to take another 4 or 5 minutes and just play different kinds of music, okay? And I want you to listen to it and walk. Again, don't try to figure out what the tune is or what figures happen or whatever. Just walk. If you need a quick drink of water, go ahead. But I just want you to walk and listen and see what your how your body changes, if at all. And maybe not. Maybe it doesn't. If you want to throw other steps in there, like a little set, or turn, you know, and turn single, whatever, a little skip, go for it. Here we go. Sorry, wait, not this. Do this one. Sorry, I'm changing it. Hold on, do this one. Bit of a crooked tune too. I kept waiting for the phrase to come around and it didn't. Okay. Did eventually, obviously. Okay, that was Whimsy Roundabout. Don't know if you noticed anything different about that. Let's see. Think about rolling through the foot. If you want to, yeah? See how it's if it's different. If that's a different thing for you than your regular walking, see how it feels different. Are you used to it? Is it weird? All right. All right, that was Apollo's Hunt. Oh, Gary Woodman dance. Okay, let's do, let's do this one. How do you move differently to this music? I love that tune. That's Smithy Hill. It's a great dance too. For me, I'll just say, that tune is a jig. It's the same time signature, and we haven't talked about this yet, but we will. But same time signature as the one I played before it, was Apollo's Hunt. But it's slower, obviously, and it feels more bluesy to me. And there's another recording by BLT, Bill Tomczyk, Kate Barnes, and Mary Lee, we were talking about that album last night, where it's a jazz, like a blues version of this tune. And so maybe that's part of my knowing that one sinking into this one. But I think this one also has a very sort of bluesy feel. So for me, I ended up kind of sinking into the floor a little bit more and moving my hips more. I don't know if you did the same, but just sort of, that feels silly, but it's, you know, this sort of wiggle, right? Because I let the music, you know, move me. I let the music kind of tell me what to do, and I let it take me away. So, and that's important, I think. That's a very important thing. And that's something I want to do more of. So, actually, since we're here, I hope that you join me for the after talk, the after chat, because I'd actually love to hear what you all are thinking, how things are affecting you, how you're moving different, if it's working for you at all, you know, if you feel like anything is different. And maybe in the future, in the week or two coming, we can try doing a meeting instead of a webinar, so we can have a little back and forth, but we'll see how that goes. But so anyway, I hope you join me afterward. But I would love to know how you're thinking about this stuff and if you feel different. I'm going to play a couple more tunes, and I want you to keep walking. But again, I want you to think about playing more. Yeah. So putting in extra little steps, if you want to. If you want to look around, move your shoulders, move your arms. We don't usually move our arms in English, except for, you know, offering a hand or a turn or whatever. If you feel like moving your arms, go ahead and move your arms. Just a little bit of improv, right? Improvisation. Improvisation is a word that kind of freaks people out a little bit. But I bet you've already been doing it just by walking around your room. So I'll play another couple of tunes with different measures, different time signatures. La, 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 let's do this one. We'll do another one. I love this dance. As much fun as I am, because I'm just goofing off at this point, but but it's fun. I'm having fun. Are you improvising a little bit? Yeah, playing with the music. Let the music take you. I know I'm not playing enough of the music to really get into it, but and sometimes it's hard to sort of listen and seems silly, but to listen and dance at the same time. Yeah, but again, we're not thinking about figures right now. We're not worried about where am I going? Am I going to crash into anybody, right? So it's okay to just listen more and let the body do what it wants to do, yeah? I'll play a waltz. Let me stop. So that tune is called, I'm going to mess it up. Intrigas no Boteco. Okay. It's from Invitation to Waltz, which is volume 14 of Bare Necessities Ball albums. And it's so fun. As you can hear, it's kind of a Brazilian, I'm guessing, Brazilian waltz. So it definitely has that flair, right? And for me, I just sort of do this, you know, almost Spanish, you know, side to side. Like, that's what my body wants to do, as if I'm, you know, I've got a bull cape or something. Seems very silly, but it's true. Yeah, so that's what this music tells me, tells my body to do. Did you feel that? Did you do anything like that? And where, I can't see you. You're home alone by yourself. So if you feel like you're foolish, nobody's gonna know. But I also bet that you do not look as foolish as you may feel. So just do it anyway. So also that tune is very fast, as you can hear. Yeah, yeah, two, three, one, two, three, one. So it's easier to do the little down, up, down, up, right? This down, up, down, up, down, up, whether I'm forward or back in a circle, yeah, waltz territory, right? As opposed to a nice, smooth, even one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, whoops, crashing the wall. All my steps are the same size with the second one, right? It's harder to do that at the tempo. But I'm going to play the same tune again. We just have a few minutes, but I'm going to play the same tune again. And I want you to try both out. Try both the waltz, down, up, up, or down, up, down. And then the smooth. Okay? See how it goes. Here we go. Yes? Did it feel different? Okay, I hope you join the chat and you can tell me. All right, but there's definitely differences in the music. And so allowing yourself to move to the music and let it tell you what to do is a big thing, yeah? It does get complicated when we start to think about actual figures, putting figures on them, and we'll do that in the future. You know, when we start to put figures on things, then you have more to think about, right? Which makes it difficult. And dancing, generally, is all about thinking about a million things at once. Yeah? Am I in the right place? Am I doing the right thing? Are my feet, you know, doing what they're supposed to? Is my body straight? Are my hips in place? Am I dropping my hip or something? Am I losing, you know, is my the bowl of my pelvis out of whack? Whatever, right? It's thinking about 100 things at once. And so that's just what dancing is. all right. In the future, I'm hoping that we will do more. We'll get faster with the warm-ups. Because you'll get more comfortable with them, hopefully. And I won't have to, if you keep coming back, which I hope you do, I won't have to teach them or break them down as quickly, and we can just go through them and be done with them sooner, and then we can get more into stuff, because I definitely want to talk, pardon me, I want to talk more about music and the different time signatures, as I mentioned. Some of that gets complicated, but I think it's very helpful to know. So we will definitely talk about time signatures and music, jigs versus reel versus slip jigs, all this good stuff. And we'll talk more about how the body moves and again, changing our dancing so that it's more graceful. We'll talk about arms more, all that stuff. I meant to do arms and I forgot. We'll talk about all that stuff. So I hope you join me again. Thank you all for coming. I want to say thanks again to Lindsay for being my tech person, and to Darlene and the Historical Tea Dance Society for helping us out with the Zoom. I want to say thank you to Bare Necessities for their incredible music and for letting me use it for this class. Again, if you're willing to, if you're willing to, if you're able to give a donation either to me or to Bare Necessities, we would both be incredibly appreciative. Anything you can do to help. I would usually charge $10 for this class, but a dollar is fine. Anything you have. I know it's hard for everybody. I hope everybody's doing well. And then I hope you join us for the after chat. You should also take a few minutes to cool down. I should do it in class, but do some of those stretches, do those calf stretches and the thigh stretches, right? Take a few minutes to do them before you join the chat room or whatever. Okay. You can do so, even do the beginning stretches and the cool, this thing, which feels really good now, right? Relax your head, all that good stuff, right? Do a little bit of a cool down, okay? And thank you for joining me. We're gonna put the splash page on and play a little bit of music, which has the information for donations. We'll play that for a few minutes, and then I'll send you the Zoom link for the after chat, and I hope you join me there. Thank you so much. See you next week.